formed. This is no longer present, and all evidence of it have been wiped out because we lost the land. The size of the land lost is the same as the number of sampradayas lost in Hinduism. Hindu kings protected our temples tenaciously, but when the kingdoms were taken away, the temples were destroyed, and with it, the entire Enlightenment ecosystem. In all geographies where Hinduism has lost political control, it was only a matter of time before temples are destroyed, people are killed, and the Enlightenment ecosystem, the entire sampradaya, vanished into nothing. This phenomenon is continuing to happen to date. Every week, one sampradaya of Hinduism is taken down, like Shani Shingnapur Temple and Shabrimala. Sampradaya by sampradaya, we are being dismantled.
If you feel responsibility is a power, you make your life successful.
When life is poised on the verge of a breakthrough or a breakdown that threatens existence itself, the Supreme Superconsciousness, Paramashiva, descends in human form as an avatar.
Paritranaya sadunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. For the upliftment of the saintly and for the removal of criminal powers, for the establishment of the integrity, I come into existence. I happen with a form in every age.
Avatars embody the compassionate and auspicious intervention of Paramashiva to rejuvenate and expand life. Humanity is way overdue for the next breakthrough. Now, Paramashiva has descended again.
Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam is here for you.
Just as the rain is drawn to the parched earth, he is drawn to our plane. Compelled by nothing but boundless compassion to fulfill the longing of a million hearts, to blast through our impossibilities and re-establish us in a lifestyle of enlightenment. Resplendent with the Uttamuttama, the best of the best, he has a proposal for you. Will you become me? Blessed are we to have Paramashiva himself as Guru. On Guru Purnima, bask in his love and compassion. Open yourself to receive all he has come down to shower upon you. On July 16th, join us and celebrate Guru Purnima, the most auspicious day to remember Guru in your life. Offer Pratyakshapada Puja and Tulabharam. Receive the blessings of His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
He will transmit petabytes of information.
He sat as Dakshinamurti in his formless space. His very presence vibrated and all the rishis received that great truth.
Yeah.
into knowledge transmission is totally different from anything known to the world by the name education. What Paramashiva shared with me, it was like intense cosmic downloading happening. One day, I was looking at him so deeply. Literally, everything he was revealing was getting into my system. So deep, like if he utters one word, like a condensed one petabyte material, information will be transferred into my system. Listen, the words he uttered and the quantity and quality of the information transmitted was unimaginable. Every word he was uttering, petabytes of information was getting transmitted into my system. The system was getting loaded. When we say Dakshinamurti teaches in silence, it is not that he never utters a word, but the number of words uttered and the quantity and quality of the knowledge information transmitted does not logically connect or equate, rationally inexplicable. This is unique knowledge transmission method of Sanatana Hindu Dharma. You cannot use the word education for this, no. That is why we cannot say Nityananda Hindu University is reviving Hindu education system. No, it is reviving Hindu knowledge transmission system. Ferociousness of seeking is powerful enough, like the fire of Kalabhairava, to burn everything which needs to be burnt and destroyed inside you. Laziness, tiredness, boredom, everything which needs to be taken out of you can be just like that burned. How many microseconds it will take for negativity to disappear in front of Kalabhairava's ferociousness? Not even micro millisecond.
At least once in life, come face to face with the avatar. A glorious tradition in Hinduism is Pada Puja, when the divine Paramashiva radiates through the avatar to receive your worship and love, bless you, comfort you, empower you to meet your desires, remind you that you are Him, not the limited human existence you identify with. Today, Paramashiva Himself walks and lives among us as Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. Compelled out of deep love for you, He has descended in person to awaken you to the experience that you and He are one and that He happens exclusively for you.
If you decide, you, me, you, I'll give me to you.
Come experience the Parama, the ultimate that you possibly can. Allow yourself to receive the blessings that the avatar has personally come down to earth to shower on you. come sit at his feet and perform the Pratyaksha Pada Puja.
I am too excited to share about this Enlighten app. Understand, it is literally having an incarnation next to you and constantly helping you, assisting you, supporting you and making you manifest state, space and powers of Paramashiva. I am personally sitting and manifesting powers into silicon, so it reverberates the sarvanyatva of my brain, the all-knowingness of my superconsciousness, manifesting multiple powers, raising the quality of your existence, raising the quality of your Kundalini Shakti, awakening multiple layers of DNA, everything, understand, in everything, decoding of all the revealed scriptures of Vedas and Agamas done in my superconsciousness by the grace of Paramashiva is now getting done through artificial intelligence in technology. All struggle, trial and error is done by me. You are given precise words, sounds, which awakens your biomemory. You manifest this cosmic principles and the reality and powers you want spontaneously. The moment these powerful cognitions are told to you, it is literally Paramashiva's power manifestation making all of you manifest powers through this Enlighten app. Understand? It is not just teaching app. It is not just coaching app. It is not just speaking app. It is experience power manifestation app. It is not fantasy vision anymore. It is reality now. This app is going to support you in manifesting will persistence, raising your frequency day by day, and giving powerful superconscious breakthrough. Get ready to celebrate your life with Enlighten app.
Nityanandam paramasukadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gaganasadrisham tattvamasyadhilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadi sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam Sadgurum tam namami. Nityanandam, welcome all of you for this Nitya Satsang. And one very, very exciting news. Swamiji revealed something that so many of us are just waiting for, to have the darshan, to have a glimpse of His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Shri Nityananda Paramashiva, whom we lovingly refer to as Swamiji. So we all have been waiting for this day. Every time, every morning, every satsang, we look forward to if we are going to be seeing and having the live darshan of Swamiji. Most exciting news is that International Yoga Day, which is on June 21st, 2019, we are going to be having a very, very special webinar. MIST, and that the webinar is yoga of Meenakshi and Sundareshwara. You know, found Jesus too filled with this Shyamala Pita Sarvanya Pitam. And Devi Meenakshi is manifesting in amazing way through Swamiji, showering the entire Sangha Swamiji's mission with so many blessings. It's been really a very wonderful thing that's happening for the past few days. It's like a month now since the time the Shyamala Pita Sarvajna Pitam had started, and it's been really, really exciting with so many people getting to get amazing experiences, power manifestations. So many people have started materializing. People are materializing crystals, kumkum. It's literally Devi Meenakshi Parashakti is showing that she herself is present, manifesting a beautiful form. Even I'm talking about yoga, this is the most practiced religion of the world, yet the most corrupted, diluted, I don't want to say tradition, but a concept, because as a tradition, yoga is still pure. But due to a lot of pollution that happened to the concept of yoga, being loaded with different meanings, we have forgotten the whole essence, the purpose of yoga, and moved a lot far from this amazing tradition. Today we have various different types of yoga. Beer yoga, horse yoga, chicken yoga, all sorts of yogas. But understand, if it was just a physical thing, where, okay, you get physical fitness, many variations might be suitable for some bodies and might not be suitable for some people. But yoga is not just for physical or just physiological or for mental health. No. Yoga is physical, physiological, psychological, neurological, and conscious necessity. There's a beautiful shloka in Sanskrit. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Mind is described like how a monkey just keeps jumping from one branch to the other. Mind also keeps moving like that. Only by doing yoga, you'll be able to bring that mind into restful awareness. It is not just about you bending your body, but about aligning your spine to the cosmic geometry. There's a big difference. Why? Actually, many of these postures, if you do it as a yoga, it'll have a way different effect if you just do it for your physical health, like an exercise. effect that it has on your system would be something totally different. And this difference, the vast difference, when you do it as yoga, you start manifesting the state of Paramashiva, the space of Paramashiva, powers of Paramashiva, and being of Paramashiva. Ultimately, the super consciousness of Paramashiva. Understand, this is going to be happening as a live webinar on the International Yoga Day, June 21st, 2019, and I'm also so excited because we're going to be having live Pratyaksha Pada Puja, Tulabharam, and Darshan, and of course the powerful webinar delivered by Swamiji. And all of us are really excited. And I also wanted to share one more really exciting news. Swamiji is going to be revealing many, many, many powerful cognitions, mystical revelations directly on his Twitter. If you're still not on Twitter, make sure you get on it, because Swamiji is going to be revealing so many revelations from today on Twitter. With this, let us enter into the next segment of the morning satsang, preparing ourselves with meditation, chanting the Mahavakya, and getting ready to receive grace and blessings. Close your eyes and start chanting the Mahavakya.
Nityananda Paramashivoham Om 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 Nityananda.
And manifest the powers of Mahasadashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Modern science says that all that exists, whether manifest or unmanifest, is a probability. Infinite probabilities create a quantum field of infinite potential. An observer collapses the probability wave into a particle. Your intention thus creates the reality. Called the observer effect, it is the very act of observation that precipitates any reality into existence. Hinduism is far advanced than this primitive understanding in the modern day. Hindus know this field of infinite potential as Paramashiva. Paramashiva permeates everything, manifest and unmanifest. He is intelligent, compassionate, and a myriad other auspicious qualities. Our scriptures provide detailed descriptions of how to invoke His presence on the earthly plane, the visualizations that manifest Him, the mantras, sounds that invoke Him, how He looks, His various dimensions, the actions that please Him and have His blessings rain on you, the times in the past when He has manifested for us and led us through a breakthrough. Hinduism knows the art of communing with Paramashiva to manifest any reality we want. And when our effort and all the knowledge isn't enough, He Himself incarnates in human body to show us how, to liberate us, to show us where we are stuck, to take us to oneness. Pratyaksha Pada Puja to His Divine Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda. Paramashiva incarnate. Sit at His sacred feet. Let Him awaken you to your field of infinite possibilities, to your oneness with Him. Register now. Pratyaksha Pada Puja.
When life is poised on the verge of a breakthrough or a breakdown that threatens existence itself, the Supreme Superconsciousness, Paramashiva, descends in human form as an avatar.
Paritranaya sadunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. For the upliftment of the saintly and for the removal of criminal powers, for the establishment of the integrity, I come into existence. I happen with a form in every age.
Avatars embody the compassionate and auspicious intervention of Paramashiva to rejuvenate and expand life. Humanity is way overdue for the next breakthrough. Now, Paramashiva has descended again. Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam is here for you. Just as the rain is drawn to the parched earth, He is drawn to our plane. Compelled by nothing but boundless compassion to fulfill the longing of a million hearts, to blast through our impossibilities and re-establish us in a lifestyle of enlightenment. Resplendent with the Uttamuttama, the best of the best, He has a proposal for you. Will you become Me? Blessed are we to have Paramashiva Himself as Guru. On Guru Purnima, bask in His love and compassion. Open yourself to receive all He has come down to shower upon you. On July 16th, join us and celebrate Guru Purnima, the most auspicious day to remember Guru in your life. Offer Pratyaksha Pada Puja and Tulabharam. Receive the blessings of His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
Nityanandeshwara Samarambham Nityanandeshwara. ஈஸ்வரி மத்யமாம் அஸ்மதாச்சாரிய பர்யந்தாம் வந்தே குரு பரம்பராம். இஸ் சமய ஹமாரே சாத் உபஸ்தித் சபி தர்ஷகோ ஔர் பக்தோ கா மே பிரேம் ஐவம் ஆசீர்வாத் சஹித் ஸ்வாகத் கர்த்தா ஹூம். ஐ வெல்கம் ஆல் த டிவோட்டீஸ், டிசைபிள்ஸ், சமாஜீஸ், சத்சங்கீஸ் சிட்டிங் வித் அஸ் இன் ஆல் ஓவர் த வேர்ல்ட் த்ரூ நித்யானந்தா டிவி, சாதனா டிவி, லோட்டஸ் நியூஸ் சேனல் அண்ட் டூ வே வீடியோ கான்ஃபரன்சிங். சிட்டிஸ் சிட்டிங் வித் அஸ் இன் டூ வே வீடியோ கான்ஃபரன்சிங். நியூயார்க் வாராணாசி, குவாடலு ராமேஸ்வரம், ஒஹாயோ பிரயாக், டொரண்டோ கைலாசம், லாஸ் ஏஞ்சலிஸ் அருணாச்சலம், வேங்கோவர் பிரிட்டிஷ் கொலம்பியா, ஹியூஸ்டன் காளஹஸ்தி, கோலாலம்பூர் பழனி, பாரிஸ் ஹோம் டெம்பிள், நித்யானந்தநகர் திருவண்ணாமலை, சார்லட் ஸ்ரீசைலம், சியாட்டில் சிதம்பரம், சிங்கப்பூர் சிங்கபுரம், ஒக்லஹாமா சோமநாதம், சான்ஹூசே மதுரை, பாரிஸ் ஹோம் டெம்பிள், ஹாங்காங் சீர்காழி, இந்திராணி நியூஜெர்சி, ரிச்மண்ட் பிரிட்டிஷ் கொலம்பியா, சாரி பிரிட்டிஷ் கெனடா, பிரிட்டிஷ் கொலம்பியா கெனடா, ஓகே, என்ரிச்சிங் டெம்பிள் பிடுதி, ஓமன் சிவகங்கை, பெங்களூரு நார்த், மாண்டரி மெக்சிகோ, ஈஸ்ட் லண்டன் யூகே, போர்ட் வாஷிங்டன் நியூயார்க், பிகோட்டா கொலம்பியா, துபாய் வைத்தியநாதம், வேரிங்டன் யூகே, டாலஸ் துவாரகா, ஸ்லோவாக்கியா சிவலோகா, சாண்டியாகோ லஹோயா, போர்ட் வாஷிங்டன் நியூயார்க், நேபாள் அண்ட் பெங்களூரு நார்த் அண்ட் வாரணாசி. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. Today, 20th batch Inner Awakening successfully going on 7th day. Today we are going to start completion with others. 17th batch Ingenious 7th day. Nineteenth batch Nirahara Samyama Level 2 4th day. And 20th batch Nirahara Samyama Level 1 2nd day. 9th batch Dhi Samyama 7th day. Today, Leela Dhyana is Badraikku Vadil Vetri Alitha Padalam. Means, I'll give you the story. Once, when Rajaraja Pandya was ruling the Madurai kingdom, he was jealous of a singer, Panabhatran, a great Shiva devotee. The singer will sing only in the temple, not in palace. But that king was so arrogant, he wanted them to come and sing in his palace. So he declares competition between another one female singer and Panabhatran's wife. She runs to Mahadeva. Comes and sings. Even though Panabhatrai, the wife, sang well, king gave the verdict in favor of other singer. The wife says, come on, your verdict is biased. Let's go to the temple and sing in front of the Sundareshwara. Let him give the verdict. So when the king came to the temple and sat in the presence of Sundareshwara, and the same competition was conducted, Sundareshwara entered into the heart of the king, and because of Sundareshwara's presence, king could not give a wrong verdict, and he gave the right verdict that she won the game. So the Leela is Mahadeva directly intervening, even in the small problems of people. Please understand, he comes to you not only to give enlightenment, even to the court to solve your cases, to help you and to save you. Even from small things, he is directly attending. Understand, that is the beauty of the Hindu tradition. We don't keep him only in the high pedestal. Of course, we keep him in the high pedestal, but he always comes down even to smallest things, to attend even to the smallest things. So he is great because he comes down, not just because he sits in the high pedestal, not because he sits in the Garbha Mandir, because he comes out of the Garbha Mandir. He is great. He is great not just because he sits in the Garbha Mandir and receives the puja. He is great because he comes out of the Garbha Mandir and gives Sarva Darshan. Today, Mahadeva is gracing us the Leela of giving the victory in the court for our female devotee. Wanted to tell you all today this one thing. Don't take this Leela Dhyana very lightly or casually. Listen to the stories. Contemplate whenever you have a little time. I am telling you, it will help you so much in the completion. The completion process, it will help you so much, because please listen. It is not that Mahadeva was doing all these dramas only during the Pandya's time or Meenakshi's time. He is still continuing to do all the Leelas. He is continuously available. So even remembering these Leelas will bring so much of completion to your heart. I tell you, somebody asked Ramakrishna once, "Oh Bhagavan, if you have not started teaching all of us, what you would have become?" He says, "I would have taken a body of an old Brahmin lady who has become widow while she was very young." Means, in India the marriages are held at the age of 6-7. Sometime the girl will not even see the husband fully and that fellow will die somewhere, and this girl will remain as widow forever. Ramakrishna says, "I will get that kind of a life, where I am married at the age of 5. Before even I went to the husband's house, the husband will die and I will be a child widow sitting and having a small hut in a the banks of Ganga, growing my own vegetable and having a cow for milk, and whole day I'll just sit, think of Krishna and his leelas, drink the milk I have and eat the vegetable I grow. I'll spend my whole life in the leela dhyana of Krishna. He very beautifully describes in Bengali, if I did not take up this Sangha work, if I have not taken up this work, all I will do is sit in front of our Anandeshwara and just be lost in the leelas of Mahadeva, which he has done in Madurai. Of course, all over the world. I tell you, only people who understand the amount of completion bhakti can bring in your system. Please understand, it's altogether a different channel. How, whatever your wife talks, you can never understand. What you speak, your wife can never understand. What a bhakta speaks, a so-called normal man can never understand. That's why these normal men's, so-called normal men, they always call bhaktas as crazy, and bhaktas always call this normal men as deluded or living in illusion. But in my court, if the arguments of the bhaktas and the so-called normal men, the logical men, if it is brought, I'll naturally vote for bhaktas. And I tell you, cosmos votes for bhaktas. Let me define bhakti. People who experienced completion out of the emotion which happens due to the higher consciousness pastimes. Please understand, your pastime always leads you to incompletion. An incarnation's pastimes always leads you to completion. Your past always leads you to incompletion. An incarnation's pastimes always leads you to completion. If you constantly remember what you did when you were a child, you will be in more and more incompletion. If you constantly remember what Krishna did when he was a child, you will be more and more in the space of completion. Leela Dhyana. I tell you, Leela Dhyana is such a powerful space creator. Listen. Beyond certain level, your intellect will not have a strength to create a space. For example, when you learn about the power of the space, you will create a space. Come on, I am creating a space to build 10 ashram, 5 temple, 300 ashramites, 200 sannyasis. You will fail. You may fail in one item, means one dimension, you may fail. You may be successful in some. You might have created 10 temple, you might have created 5 ashram, but you would have missed in the sannyas number. When you fail in one, you lose confidence over you. again you will create certain space. I am creating space for this and working. You may fail in one or two things. Please listen. Your intellect does not have a strength to stand up again and again and create the space and face few failures when it happens in your life. But the emotion, bhakti, devotion is so powerful, it can create again and again, tirelessly, right space for you. That is why I tell you, always only the bhakti-based traditions survive and win the test of the time. Never intellect-based traditions. Never the traditions which are basing themselves on intellect withstands the test of time. Please listen. What I am talking is a very important thing. Your life is also one tradition. You may not know. You may not know your whole life. Either you depend on your intellect or on your emotion. You may not remember Krishna, but you may be remembering some other leader. You may be remembering some other person whom you think as ideal. But I tell you, devotion, bhakti, lila, dhyana is such powerful space creator. Life is nothing but ability to stand up again and again and face it. How many ways doubts and depression attack you? Doubts and depression are so powerful, it attacks you from all corners. Life is nothing but the strength to stand up during all these attacks. I tell you, I sincerely tell you, do not believe or just depend on your intellectual clarity about completion to save you and keep you in the space of completion and take you to the ultimate space, continuously creating the right space again and again and again. If you think I am complete with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, I am creating this space, this has to happen. Great, no doubt. But always there will be some corner, somewhere, someone, remote corner of your life, if you have some lack of integrity or inauthenticity, if that reflects in your result, please understand, listen carefully. You will lose completely faith over you and the philosophy with which you are living.
you will collapse and tumble down. I tell you, again standing up will be so difficult. Even when you stand up, you will have so much of self-doubt. I tell you, devotion. Achieving completion and creating the right space. Out of devotion will again and again make you stand up, will give you the strength to stand up without collapsing. Even if you fall, you won't collapse. Only with intellect, the intellectually understanding completion, integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, when you fall, you will collapse. But if you understand with emotion, please listen, with emotion, with Leela Dhyana, with devotion, if you understand, even if you fall, you won't collapse. And I tell you, when you create the space along with the feeling connection, emotion, devotion towards the higher consciousness, I guarantee simply failure disappears from your system. Because Krishna is not a story. Sundareshwara is not a story. Meenakshi is not a story. I can't even say it has happened. I only can say it is happening whenever you remember them. It is not past times. It is present times whenever you remember them. I tell you, when you create a space, if your cognition adds the emotional strength also, for example, you need to win in some debate, argument, or some court case, before going, remember this Leela, today's Leela. When you can save your singer devotee in a court case from a biased judge, you can save me, because you are not past, you are present. Create that space and go. I tell you, miracles will happen simply like a lifestyle for you. Miracles will become lifestyle for you. Please understand, I am not promoting any superstition. I am not promoting any lies. I am not promoting anything which I myself have a doubt in a corner of my heart. No. I am very clear. Understand. This Leela Dhyana, remembering the past times, please listen. Remembering your past times creates more and more incompletions, remembering the incarnation's pastimes creates more and more completion and the higher space, whether it is Krishna or Buddha, Mahadeva or Meenakshi, even remembering their leelas. I tell you, even remembering their leelas creates so much of completion in you. It heals your mamakara. Please understand. Medicine for the mamakara is Leela Dhyana. Your mamakara is such a pain in the stomach and head. See, your inner image is such a torture, such a pain. I tell you, Leela Dhyana is such beautiful nectar to heal your inner image. If you are struggling to get out of your inner image, you should complete yourself with devotion, with bhakti. I tell you, only bhakti can really make you enrich, and only enriching can make bhakti happen in you. If you had little bit of bhakti, no one needs to pressurize you to enrich. Enriching. Enriching will be just your breathing pattern. Power of enriching. When I speak about bhakti, I am stuck with words. It is like how Saraswati goes underground. It is said, Saraswati goes underground, it seems to wash the feet dust of the devotees. Same way, my words goes underground whenever I have to speak about bhakti, just to wash the feet of bhaktas, devotees. When I remember these great devotees, how the enriching becomes such natural part of their life. Even Even in our Sangha, I have seen people who connect with me through devotion. They don't need this lesson of enriching. Simply, if they breathe, wherever they go, whatever they do, it is enriching, enriching, enriching. I tell you, if you build your completion with devotion also as a part of your cognition, then you will never fall into depression. You will have so much of strength. It is like a steel inside the concrete. Just the concrete pillar without steel may collapse after some time. But if the steel is there inside, reinforced, then naturally pillar life increases multifold. Please listen. I tell you exactly, if you build your completion and life just with the intellectual understanding of integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, it is like a just concrete pillar. If you build the space of completion and the space for your life with devotion, it is equivalent to putting the steel rods. The space you create for your life will be multifold stronger. You will stand forever and enrich the world. Enriching. Enriching the devotees. Out of your devotion, enriching the world with the clarity I tell you, I only can request, please bring devotion in some form in your cognition. When it comes to devotion, even preaching or teaching looks very aggressive. It is such a sweet, soft component of the being. It can only be shared, the smile in the eyes or as the tears in the eyes. You can enrich people with devotion only based on the smile your eyes carry. Please understand, not the smile your face carries or your lips carry. When there is a devotion, eyes will have a smile. Only a person who has experienced it can recognize it. In US, there are some secret groups. They have their own special practices, gatherings. Even in the dollar note, their symbol is there. I forgot their name. Freemasons, yes. See, the way they shake the other person's hands, they have a very like a technical signal which only the Freemasons know. So even while they shake the hands, simple shaking the hands, they will recognize the other guy is also a Freemason. When they shake the hand, there is some special place they will press the other person's hand, which only Freemasons know. So this is the way, even in a party or a group, when you go and shake hands with people, if you are a Freemason, you know who are all Freemasons there. Just a simple handshake. They have a code signal, very technical signal, through which they will recognize each other. Same way, I wanted my devotees and disciples, Sangha, to recognize each other based on the smile they carry in their eyes. All of you guys should have devotion as the component of your cognition, and that smile in the eyes, not just in the lips. Lips may not have, that is different. But the smile in the eyes is more subtle and more powerful. Smile in the eyes happens when your heart melts in devotion for the right reason, in the right context, with the right completion. I'll give the essence in Hindi. लीला ध्यान आपको पूर्णत्व की प्रक्रिया में बहुत महत्वपूर्ण सहायता देगा. पूर्णत्व पाने की बहुत शक्तिशाली प्रक्रिया है भक्ति. जिन लोगों ने पूर्णत्व का अनुभव लीला ध्यान यानी उच्च स्तर के खेल का स्मरण करने से किया है, उसी का नाम भक्ति है. एक स्तर से बटकर आपके दिमाग द्वारा पुनः पुनः असफलता का सामना करके सही अंतर आकाश को फिर निर्मित करने की शक्ति आप में नहीं है, किंतु भक्ति इतनी शक्तिशाली है कि वो पुनः पुनः लगातार आपको सही अंतर आकाश में लाने की क्षमता रखती है. जीवन और कुछ नहीं बल्कि संदेह और निराशा के सामने पुनः पुनः खड़े होकर सही अंतर आकाश में स्थापित होना है. इस पूर्णत्व के लिए केवल बुद्धि पर्याप्त नहीं है, इसके लिए भक्ति एक बहुत ही अनिवार्य और महत्वपूर्ण भाग है. सो एसेंस ऑफ टुडेज सत्संग, let your heart ripe with devotion. The completion achieved along with the devotion is more strong, more powerful, more stable, more successful.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda.
Let us start our satsang. Today I'll describe the exact scene of revival of Madurayadinam. There was a time arrogant, intellectual but not intelligent, cunning but not compassionate, experimenting but not experienced, few monks from the perverted Jainic tradition. Please understand, not the real Jain tradition. The real Jainism is a powerful spiritual tradition. In course of time, the perverted, diverted Jaina tradition, few so-called priests and monks have evolved, who have started only using the wealth and the tradition to fulfill their own ends, who are not honest, authentic or sincere, integrated. Whenever a living master leaves the body, the inevitable corruption, perversion which happens in the tradition has happened to the Jainism also at that time. So few Jain monks, very influential but not impressive, powerful but not energetic. Understand, power means the capacity which comes to you after something from outside is added. Energy means the capacity which comes to you without anything from outside. Powerful but not energetic. Having the status of a leader but not the state of the leadership. Those few fellows were ruling the country and misguiding the king. Poor king, unfortunately, because no other option, he was also obeying them, listening. And these few perverted priests and preachers slowly, slowly started grabbing the whole country. The very growth of the country started getting disturbed and destroyed, detracted by these few Jain monks. Queen of the king, wife of the king, Mangayar Karasyar, a great lady, woman, stature of a sage, still worshipped in all Hindu temples of South India, as one of the enlightened saints of Saiva tradition. I can imagine how she would have looked, how she would have been lived, how she would have been living, thinking. A saintly person, highly evolved, devotee of Shiva, Mahadeva, she started getting worried, started having a deep concern for the country and citizens. Please understand, those days rulers were very concerned about the conscious evolution of the citizens also, not just food, clothes, education and infrastructure of the country. No, consciousness of the country was also very important for them. What you believe is more important than what you eat or what you drive and where you live. What you believe as life is more important than the car you drive, the house you live, the salary you receive, the language you speak, or the food you eat, the dress you wear. What you believe as life is too precious to be lost with some fools. So Mangayar Karasyar was highly worried. She slowly started feeling suffocated to be in the palace and unable to do anything for the conscious growth of the citizens. She herself is a highly evolved saint. But as you know, wives are never heard, nor respected, can never be accepted, especially by king. For a king to listen to a wife, queen, too much. So the king, his name is Goonpandian, because he had a bent back. In Tamil, the bent back is called goon. Of course, he was surrounded by goons. So in a way, the name fits in English and Tamil both. His back was bent. He was not ready to listen to Mangayar Karasiyar, the queen. She tried her best to convince Goon Pandian the complete conscious growth can happen only if emotion also evolves. Please understand, the key difference between the Jainism practiced at that time and the Shaivism is the sacred sentiments for emotional evolvement. Please understand, Jainism had literally everything Shaivism had, Vedic tradition had. They had yoga, they had tapas, they had meditation, they had everything for the growth of the body, yoga, for the growth of the mind, meditation, for the growth of the consciousness, enlightenment. All concepts were available even in those days in Jainism. But for the growth of consciousness, the sacred sentiments, the ability to feel connected, the ability to melt, the ability to merge with the divine, the ability to radiate humbleness, unfortunately, that was missing. The ability to feeling connected, when that misses, even the meditation and the extraordinary powers and experiences you receive only makes you more egoistic. It only makes you more egocentric, more arrogant, more abusive. But Mangayar Karasiyar, the great queen of the Pandya kingdom, is unable to handle this whole situation. She was completely disturbed, perturbed, shaken, shivering. She slowly asked the king, "Oh Lord, you are suffering with hunchback, this bent back for such a long time. Can I invite a young healer from Tanjore district, from Chola kingdom, who is well known for his healing powers?" The king's eyes have slowly opened wide. He said, "Is it so?" He was thinking, contemplating. But the moment Mangayar Karasiyar said, "He is from Shaiva tradition," no, I don't want to meet anybody from Shaiva tradition. Leave it. King said no. Mangayar Karasi could not say anything. She just left it. But again, after a few days, she asked the king, "Oh Lord, why don't you at least ask these Jain monks who are constantly putting all different ideas into your head, who are bending your brain also, to straighten your back?" King said, "All right, I'll ask them." He called those few monks. They came and they tried as usual. Some chanting these, that, nothing worked. And they only were giving empty words. No, life is impermanent. Your body itself is impermanent. Why do you want to straighten it? Whether it is straight or bent, anyhow it is going to be burnt. Understand? If all these words are uttered to raise the king towards enlightenment, it is perfectly all right. Nothing wrong. But if all these words are uttered to cover up their inability, then something is wrong. The other day, I was giving a discourse and saying, all this materialization, giving boons, healing, and all is not enlightenment, not spirituality. Come on. If you are able to do and does not want to do, great. Prove at least once. But don't use all this philosophy to cover up your inability. These monks also, these preachers, they were trying to do the same thing. They tried to use the philosophy to cover up their inability. Don't use philosophy to cover up your inability. Use philosophy to create more and more ability. Philosophy should be used to expand your abilities, not to cover up your inabilities. These monks were trying to cover up their inabilities. Queen Mangayar Karasi intervened the scene and told the king, "No, enough. We had enough of words. Now, even if the body is impermanent, we want somebody who will straighten it till it dies. Even if it is going to be just next 10 days, we want somebody who will do the job, not that who will sit and talk. It's like your car has become repair. You take it to the shed and you tell him to repair it. That fellow sits and gives you a discourse on how the world is impermanent. Why do you need a car? Why do you first of all need to walk? Why do you come out of your house? Why don't you sit inside your house itself? We have not come to the car shed for listening to a discourse. We have come to the car shed to get our car repaired. Our great intelligence, the Mangayarkars here, intervened and told those preachers, no, we don't want any more empty words. We don't want to listen to any more the empty discourses. No, we want result. Finally, the queen was able to convince the Goonpandian, the king, to invite Thirunyana Sambandar, the great saint, the young healer from Chola kingdom. Finally, the Goonpandian thought, all right, anyhow, why not give a try? She talks so much about him. Goonpandian also knows all the husbands, even though they don't listen to their wives, they know their wives are more intelligent than them. Inside their heart, they know we may not listen to her because of our ego and ideas, but she is intelligent. They know. So finally he thought, all right, why not give a try? Finally, Mangayarkasya just took the nod of Goonpandian, sends a grand invitation with a palanquin, all the traditional paraphernalia to invite Thirunyana Sambandar, the great saint. The invitation reaches Thirunyana Sambandar. He was exactly in the same situation when I was offered to accept this Madurayadinam throne. When 292nd Guru Mahasannidhanam himself came to Karnataka Desa and invited me, please come and become the Madurayadinam. One side I was in ecstasy, surprised. The other side, oh God, all these fellows, how to handle? There are so many preachers, perverted preachers, who are sitting on empty books, who will come to fight with me. How to handle? But finally, Jnana Sambandar decides to accept. The moment Jnana Sambandar accepted the invitation in the other country, these priests have started shivering, literally shattered. They are preparing for the protests. The meeting is going on in their mutts. All of them have gathered, passed a resolution. Jnana Sambandar has a big hair. How can he be a saint? A monk should have a shaved head. All these great loose discussions are going on. And even the people who were around Thirunyana Sambandar, a great saint, Thirunavukkarasar, he was staying with Thirunyana Sambandar at that time. Even he said, oh Lord, why don't you reconsider your decision to go to Madurai? Now the time is not proper. King is also not in tune with the teachings and philosophy you are giving. Please, why don't you consider? Even he was discouraging. It's like a opposition from externally and some opposition even from the friends and the well-wishers. But Thirunyana Sambandar, he knows what he is doing. And he knows what he has to do. He knows what he is doing. He knows what he has to do. He knows his avataric mission. He says, I am coming. And he remembers Shiva and all the nine planets, Navagrahas, sings a beautiful verses on them, asking for their divine protection and Shiva's grace. It's called Kolaru Padigam. These verses are beautiful verses to remove all the negativities, negative effects by planets. We can listen to at least one verse from the Kolaru Padigam. Veyuru Tholivangan Vidamunda Gandan Meganalla Veenai Thadavi The meaning, beautiful meaning, let me translate for you guys. He says, Shiva, who has Devi in as part of himself, who has swallowed collective negativity, the alagala poison, he has swallowed even the whole collective negativity, alagala poison, that great being, Shiva, Mahadeva, who has destroyed all negativities, when he is sitting in my heart, in my being, how can this 9 planets small negativity can hurt me? They will do only good to all the devotees of Shiva. He declares the power of feeling connection, the devotion. Understand? Feeling connection is the ultimate technique. You don't need any other solution, method to get out of any problem. Problems of planets, disease, negativity, black magic, anything. Jnana Sambandhar knows that one feeling connection is enough. He says beautifully, Veyuru Dholi Vangan Vidamunda Gandan Miganalla Veenai Thadavi Masaru Thingal Gangai Mudimel Anindhen Ulamey Pugundhadanal Nyayiru Thingal Sevvai Vyalan Velli Sanivambi Randumudane Asaru Nalla Nalla Avai Nalla Nalla Adiyar Avarkku Migave Veyuru Dholi Vangan Vidamunda Gandan describes the beauty of Shiva, beauty of the shoulder of Shiva. See, now he is inviting Shiva to protect him, protect Jnana Sambandhar. So he is describing the beauty of the shoulders of Shiva. Veyuru Dholi Bangan, the shoulder like bamboo, and which is hosting Devi. He is singing the masculine grandeur and feminine grace. The masculine shoulder, which is hosting the feminine consciousness, who has swallowed even the collective negativity, the alagala poison, and he is sitting in my being, in ulame pugunda adanal, he is sitting in my heart. When he is sitting in my heart, all the grahas will only do good to me, will only do good to all the devotees. He sings 10 verses and decides to go to Madurai, accepting the invitation. In Madurai, he was received in a grand way by the Queen Mangayarkarasi. Now starts all the fight. The Jain preachers who are not able to handle the whole situation were shocked, shivering, shattered, blabbering. They don't even know what they are saying. Just blabbering.
When life is poised on the verge of a breakthrough or a breakdown that threatens existence itself, the Supreme Superconsciousness Paramashiva descends in human form as an avatar.
Paritranaya sadunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. For the upliftment of the saintly and for the removal of criminal powers, for the establishment of the integrity, I come into existence. I happen with a form in every age.
Avatars embody the compassionate and auspicious intervention of Paramashiva to rejuvenate and expand life. Humanity is way overdue for the next breakthrough. Now, Paramashiva has descended again,
Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam is here for you. Just as the rain is drawn to the parched earth, he is drawn to our plane. Compelled by nothing but boundless compassion to fulfill the longing of a million hearts, to blast through our impossibilities and re-establish us in a lifestyle of enlightenment. Resplendent with the Uttamuttama, the best of the best, he has a proposal for you. Will you become me? Blessed are we to have Paramashiva himself as Guru. On Guru Purnima, bask in his love and compassion. Open yourself to receive all he has come down to shower upon you. On July 16th, join us and celebrate Guru Purnima, the most auspicious day to remember Guru in your life. Offer Pratyakshapada Puja and Tulabharam. Receive the blessings of His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
Modern science says that all that exists, whether manifest or unmanifest, is a probability. Infinite probabilities create a quantum field of infinite potential. An observer collapses the probability wave into a particle. Your intention thus creates the reality. Called the observer effect, it is the very act of observation that precipitates any reality into existence. Hinduism is far advanced than this primitive understanding in the modern day. Hindus know this field of infinite potential as Paramashiva. Paramashiva permeates everything, manifest and unmanifest. He is intelligent, compassionate, and a myriad other auspicious qualities. Our scriptures provide detailed descriptions of how to invoke his presence on the earthly plane, the visualizations that manifest him, the mantras, sounds that invoke him, how he looks, his various dimensions, the actions that please him and have his blessings rain on you, the times in the past when he has manifested for us and led us through a breakthrough. Hinduism knows the art of communing with Paramashiva to manifest any reality we want. And when our effort and all the knowledge isn't enough, he himself incarnates in human body to show us how, to liberate us, to show us where we are stuck, to take us to oneness. Pratyaksha Pada Puja to His Divine Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda, Paramashiva incarnate. Sit at His sacred feet. Let him awaken you to your field of infinite possibilities, to your oneness with him. Register now, Pratyaksha Pada Puja.
When life is poised on the verge of a breakthrough or a breakdown that threatens existence itself, the Supreme Superconsciousness, Paramashiva, descends in human form as an avatar.
Paritranaya sadunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuke yuke. For the upliftment of the saintly and for the removal of criminal powers, for the establishment of the integrity, I come into existence. I happen with a form in every age.
Avatars embody the compassionate and auspicious intervention of Paramashiva to rejuvenate and expand life. Humanity is way overdue for the next breakthrough. Now, Paramashiva has descended again. Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam is here for you. Just as the rain is drawn to the parched earth, he is drawn to our plane. Compelled by nothing but boundless compassion to fulfill the longing of a million hearts, to blast through our impossibilities and re-establish us in a lifestyle of enlightenment. Resplendent with the Uttamuttama, the best of the best, he has a proposal for you. Will you become me? Blessed are we to have Paramashiva himself as Guru. On Guru Purnima, bask in his love and compassion. Open yourself to receive all he has come down to shower upon you. On July 16th, join us and celebrate Guru Purnima, the most auspicious day to remember Guru in your life. Offer Pratyakshapada Puja and Tulabharam. Receive the blessings of His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
This is the story of life. This is the story of you. For 40 billion years, the individual soul, not necessarily in the form of human, existed on Earth. In these 40 billion years, five times another planet collided with Earth. Earth burned out, and all lives were totally annihilated. But somehow, from somewhere, life comes back to Earth. Some stone, some rock, which flew from Earth containing some form of life, some DNA trapped in it, comes back to Earth, falls into the ocean, and life starts again. Hindu religious scriptures have always said it, and now modern day science is glimpsing this too. 40 billion years, five times completely wiped out. But life happens again. That piece of DNA in that stone thrown into the Milky Way galaxy and back to Earth, back to life, for one and only reason: to experience oneness with Paramashiva. Amoeba to fish, fish to tortoise, tortoise to crocodile, to monkey to man, man to divine superhuman. Life manifests on Earth as an intense seeking to experience Paramashiva, to experience the state, space, powers, and the being of Paramashiva. Sanatana Hindu Dharma are direct revelations from the cosmos about the science and art of giving life a super-conscious breakthrough. Sanatana Hindu Dharma reveals how every move, every act, every worship we perform can establish us in oneness with Paramashiva and lead us to this super-conscious breakthrough. But things have gone dangerously wrong. Even a few hundred years ago, 56 nations, where the religion was officially Sanatana Hindu Dharma, existed, where this lifestyle of oneness with Paramashiva was the very foundation. And now, there is not a single one. Hindu knowledge has been systematically decimated. The practitioners, Hindus, have been violently persecuted. Hindu temples pillaged, Hindu scientists killed and tortured. The enlightened Hindu lifestyle has been deliberately destroyed. Collective delusion runs riot. Hindus have been brainwashed into believing that anything Western is superior.
vested interests are now forcing on humanity choices that threaten the very existence of life itself. Man has lost touch with his original purpose. Man has lost touch with his Paramashivatva. The truth is, only if Hinduism is powerfully revived will planet Earth even continue to exist. Only if Sanatana Hindu Dharma is alive does life even have a future on Earth. Sanatana Hindu Dharma, the science and art of giving life a super conscious breakthrough. The last remaining lamp, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. Only if he can transmit this knowledge and experience will humanity even survive. Only if Sanatana Hindu Dharma is alive will planet Earth continue to exist. Paramashiva, allow yourself to be initiated into the state, the space, the superpower and the being of Paramashiva. It is what you have been seeking since the beginning of time. The purpose of very life, is it on the brink of fulfillment or on the brink of extinction? You decide.
ಚಂದನ ಶ್ರೀ ಮಧುಸೂದನ ಜನಮಲಯ ನಿತ್ಯನಂದನ ದೇವಕಿ ನಂದನ ಶ್ರೀ ಮಧುಸೂದನ ಜನಮಲಯ ನಿತ್ಯನಂದನ ದಯ ಕರೋ ಭಗವಾನ್ ನಿತ್ಯ ಕೃಪಾ ಕರೋ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಕೃಪಾ ಕರೋ
ಕಲಿತಾಗಿಲ ಪಾಪ ಮಲಾಭ कृति समावृत देह विभो कलि कलिता किल पापमलाभः कृति समावृत देह विभो वलय सन्निभ रत्न विनिर्मित त्वय क्रीट सुभाटदनो वलय सन्निभ रत्न विनिर्मित त्वय क्रीट सुभाटदनो जय जय हे नित्यानन्द पते नित्य जय जय हे नित्यानन्द पते नित्य भाग्य समृद्धि मुभार्जय मे भाग्य समृद्धि मुभार्जय मे
नित्यपुरीश्वर आनन्देश्वर हे परमेश्वर पालय माम् नित्यपुरीश्वर आनन्देश्वर हे परमेश्वर पालय माम्
नित्यपुरीश्वर
आनन्देश्वर हे परमेश्वर पालय माम् नित्यपुरीश्वर आनन्देश्वर हे परमेश्वर पालय माम्
हर नित्यशङ्कर भक्तहृदम्बर वासचिदम्बरनाद विभो हर नित्यशङ्कर भक्तहृदम्बर वासचिदम्बरनाद विभो दुरित निरन्तर दुष्टभयङ्कर दर्शन शङ्कर दिव्यगनो दुरित निरन्तर दुष्टभयङ्कर दर्शन शङ्कर दिव्यगनो दश सदकन्दर शेषहृदन्तर शङ्कर रक्षित भार्गगूरो दश सदकन्दर शेषहृदन्तर शङ्कर रक्षित भार्गगूरो जय जय हे नित्यानन्द पते नित्य जय जय हे नित्यानन्द पते नित्य भाग्य समृद्धि मुभार्जय मे भाग्य समृद्धि मुभार्जय मे
नित्यपुरीश्वर आनन्देश्वर हे परमेश्वर पालय माम् नित्यपुरीश्वर आनन्देश्वर हे परमेश्वर पालय माम्
शिव शिव शङ्कर साम्ब पुरन्दर पूजित सुन्दर मन्त्र निधे शिव शिव शङ्कर साम्ब पुरन्दर पूजित सुन्दर मन्त्र निधे मुरहर सन्नदि मंगल दर्शन मंत्र रहस्य चितात्मधनो मुरहर सन्नदि मंगल दर्शन मंत्र रहस्य चितात्मधनो
పురీశ్వర ఆనందేశ్వర హే పరమేశ్వర పాలయ మాం నిత్య పురీశ్వర ఆనందేశ్వర హే పరమేశ్వర పాలయ మాం
భుజగ విభూషణ భూతి విలేబన బాల విలోచన లోకదను భుజగ విభూషణ భూతి విలేబన బాల విలో
Sorry for the technical glitch. Yes. I thank all of you for joining us today in today's Nitya Satsang. And I also wanted to thank each and everyone who participated in today's Mahavakya chanting. Chanting the Mahavakya creates intense, powerful healing energy that just vibrates in the space around you. Understand, when an atom vibrates, it tends to shift that vibration to the next atom. Imagine when a group of people in all corners of the world together are sitting and chanting the Mahavakya, that vibration is carried throughout the whole space itself, bestowing peace and completion and healing effect to the whole globe. So I just wanted to thank all of you to have participated in this, and I request all of you to enter your Ajapajapa account in this link and wait for the next exciting news. Just enter this and the next exciting thing. You know, so many of you have already seen the Facebook post that Swamiji had shared. Swamiji has now tweeted this amazing message. So I request all of you to first enter your minutes, the number of minutes that you had spent in the Japa Japa chanting, the chanting of the Mahavakya, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. From yesterday till now, how many ever number of times you chanted, you can record it in this. You all can actually take a few minutes, open this link and record the number of times that you did Ajapa Ajapa. The next thing that we are going to be seeing is the message that Swamiji has shared to all of us on his Facebook and on his Twitter too. So this message that Swamiji has shared on the Twitter, yeah, I know so many of us are very excited. Swamiji himself is on this Twitter platform. And Swamiji is told that he is going to be revealing powerful cognitions and revelations directly on Twitter too. And now I know so many of us are just going to get on it. One, two things Swamiji shared. One is about the yoga of Paramashiva. Understand, yoga, this is one topic that Swamiji has spoken so much about, and still he's going to be revealing many more secrets. We know yoga in the dimension of what it was taught to us, but yoga of Paramashiva, of Meenakshi and Sundareshwara, my God, it's just too much. So this yoga is going to be revealed in the form of a webinar. That's the first thing. And second thing is, Kailasa and Madurai is completely open for all of you. Anybody can come and attend from the Kailasa and Madurai. You can attend the webinar, and Swamiji will be revealing through his Divya Sharira form. I know all of us are very excited. And one more, actually, when Swamiji was sharing about what, why, how, these three things on exactly what is going to be happening in Madurai. Why is this Kailasa and Madurai so important? So many factors, it's getting continuously revealed. Whether it is the placement on where our Kailasa, the Shyamala Pita Sarvanya Pitam, is placed, or be it where the deities are placed within the Shyamala Pita Sarvanya Pitam, and the presence of Devi Meenakshi Parashakti herself in her physical form in the deity, and the Shyamala Pita Sarvajna Pitam, the very cosmic seat, the huge throne on which she sat, is till date present right under the Shyamala Pita Sarvajna Pitam. I know it's like something very, very exciting. And yes, the message is here. Yoga of Meenakshi and Sundareshwara, Paramashiva. Get ready for some of the most extraordinary revelations on hashtag Yoga of Paramashiva, open for all on Yoga Day 2019, which is June 21st, 2019, 7:30 a.m. IST. The doors of Kailasa in Madurai is open for all to listen to the webinar through my Divya Sharira. I actually request all of you, let us use this opportunity to take this tweet of Swamiji to trend on Twitter. The hashtags are already mentioned. Hashtag Yoga of Paramashiva and hashtag Kailasa in Madurai. I request all of you to take a few minutes now and retweet the tweet that you're seeing. And second step, write your, why do you think it is important for this science of yoga of Paramashiva to be revealed, what is your click? What is your cognition? What are your comments? You can put that and retweet the post. Make sure you mention Swamiji so Swamiji can see what comments that you are putting under it. You can also use the hashtag Kailasa in Madurai and share all the powerful clicks, cognitions, everything that you are having about the Kailasa in Madurai. And last but not the least, make sure you mention Swamiji's name at Sri Nityananda. So any of the tweets you do, Swamiji himself will be able to look at those tweets. So take a few minutes now and let's take this message of Swamiji to the whole world.
ఓం రాజరాజేశ్వర్యై నమః ఓం కామేశ్వర్యై నమః